Hi everyone, and welcome to DevTools Tutorial Part 14, which starts a series of episodes about designing arenas. There will be four such episodes, and their topics will be as follows. First, we'll show you how to set a playable area, that is, how to restrict the area where the game takes place, and how to change the weather condition. Second, we'll create an alarm siren triggered by the player. In the third episode, we'll prepare spawners for AI waves. Finally, we'll combine all these elements into a quest that will make you survive zombie hordes for a set period of time in a set area after disabling the siren. Okay, so let's start with the basics and change the time of the day and weather. First, open the varless window by clicking the sun icon on the toolbar. In the window, use the first slider to change the time of the day to 8:30 p.m. Use the second slider to select fog. Just slide it to the left. Now we can move on to setting up the arena. We'll start with its logic placement on the map. Let's assume that the player will be surrounded by a wall. We'll now go to object types and plate the playable area point, which will outline an area that the player cannot leave. When you add more points, they're automatically connected, so they create a borderline. To close the area, go to the attributes window of the last playable area point and check the next box. Next, holding the control key, right-click on the first playable area point and from the context menu select Add to Next. Selecting all playable area points, go to the attributes and decrease the range to 2 meters. This value determines how far the player will be able to go beyond that area. For playable area points to work properly, you also need a playable area controller. Select one of the area points and add a playable area controller from the object types. The controller will be automatically connected to your area. What's more, you can decide what the player is and is not allowed to do. For example, you can disable the ability to climb. We should also name the area, because we're going to disable it after the quest is complete, so the player can leave that place. Let's smooth out our playable area points. To do so, you can copy pivot positions from the other objects and paste them to the playable area points. In the attributes window, under tab matrix, select a fragment of, for instance, the lawn and click copy. Then select the playable area point and click paste. Finally, our area is ready for the player. Let's just place the starting point in the middle of the arena and check if our playable area works in the game. As you can see, it's impossible to climb the wall. And when you leave the area, the HUD displays an appropriate message and you're brought back to the starting point. The playable area is finished. In the next episode, we'll show you how to create an alarm siren. Thank you for watching.